Thank you for inviting me to present today. Yes, I will speak about the AM at Siemens in Finspång and what we do there. And this is the outline. First, some brief introduction to Siemens and AM. And then I will speak about the gas turbine focal areas for AM. Rapid prototyping, rapid repair and spare parts on demand, and rapid manufacturing. And then some words on research areas and challenges ahead. Is the sound okay? Some words about us. Siemens Industrial Turbomachinery is part of the whole global Siemens company. We produce gas turbines, and gas turbines as part of a turnkey power generation. We export 95% of our products, but we do some things here in Sweden. As we are in Gothenburg today, I must mention the Ryaverken, where we have three gas turbines and one of our steam turbines, producing approximately one third of the power needed in Gothenburg and one third of the district heating. We are about 2,800 persons employed in Finspång, and about 400 persons in the R&D department. But we also have the close collaboration with Siemens globally, about 30,000 persons working within the R&D community there. Some words then about AM. In 2015, we invested in an AM workshop in Finspång. And we now have 12 EOS machines installed. It's three M290s, four M400 Quattros, four M280, which are specially built to fit one of our repair processes that I will talk about later on, and one of the M270 machines. And when it comes to the gas turbine, the focus for AM for us have been the complex parts with complex geometry and need for cooling and need for mixing of fuels. So we have identified the combustion system and the turbine as the primary focus areas. And in the combustion system, we're looking at the burners and also swirlers, nozzles, filters and mixers. And when it comes to turbines, we target the heat shields and vanes. And for the highly loaded rotating blades, we are now looking at prototyping for that. And we're also looking at some smaller seal segments and orifices, etc. Some words on the background and history regarding AM at Siemens in Finspång. Started out in 2008 with an analysis of the AM value chain, which led to the installation of our first machine in 2009, an EOS M270, which was installed in one of our regular workshops. And in 2012, we installed the first EOS M280 machine, which was then adapted to fit our burner tip repair process. And in 2013, the first sets of repaired burners by SLM were installed at the customer engine. And also the same year, first set of burner swirlers were installed in commercial operation at customer engines. In 2014, Siemens globally, in the large gas turbine units, founded the organization Manufacturer Development and Industrialization to further promote the use of advanced manufacturing techniques. And 2015, we started the serial production for this rapid burner tip repair. And we also had the first fire of a fully burner printed, not only the tip. I will show you more on that later on. And in 2016, we had the formal inauguration of the AM workshop in the Finspång site, which you see a picture of here. And in 2016, we also acquired a 3D printing firm in the UK called Material Solutions, which is now owned by Siemens, and we collaborate closely with them as well. And the target is to have over 100,000 3D printed parts annually from 2020 and onwards. So why do we use SLM? Well, there are two areas you could say. It's the lead time and it's the efficiency improvement, the functionality that we can gain by this method. When it comes to lead time reduction and life cycle improvement, we're looking at these complex parts and we see that we can have a faster technology validation and a faster product development, making the time to market shorter. We see also that we can reduce the number of steps, we can integrate so that the component is made out of fewer or ideally only one part. We can save material, and we can eliminate tooling. And from the efficiency side of it, our parts needs cooling, and we can create better heat transfer with the freedom of geometry that AM can provide. We can have thinner walls, larger surface areas, and lattice structures, for example. We can also improve the mixing of fuel and air in our burner systems, enabling to burn other type of fuels, for example, hydrogen, which is much better for the environment. We can decrease the use of coating if we cool better for some applications. And we also look at the possibility for new powder alloy compositions to further improve the lifetime of the components. So those are the main drivers identified. So we are speaking at Siemens about the three pillars of AM. So I will go into some examples of that. The first one is rapid prototyping. And there we have the example of rotating turbine blades, which are the most highly loaded components in the engine. This is now a process that we have validated. And the target is to have bolder designs and to reduce the time to market. The other area we call the rapid repair and spare parts on demand. We use that, for example, on the SKT 700 and 800 gas turbines. And the burner tip repair that I mentioned can save lead time up to a factor of 10 and is something that we now use commercially. And when it comes to manufacturing rapidly, we're looking at a complete remanufacturing of the burner front, where we see that we can improve the design, we can improve the fuel flexibility, increasing the percentage of mixing in hydrogen, for example. We can decrease weight and less waste of it. And that is also now installed commercially. So, some words on the prototyping. During the past year, we validated a process where we could produce different designs of our most highly component, the first stage turbine blade, and validate it in a real engine test. And just to give a hint on what this blade is submitted to, it's rotating it at 13,600 RPM. Meaning it feels the velocity of 480 meters per second. So the blade, which is about this size and weighs 180 grams, will take the load of approximately 11 tons in that speed. And at the same time, it's submitted to hot gas of 1280 degrees Celsius, means that it has a complex cooling system on the inside. And the cooling air is around 400 degrees. And for us, it's really important to keep track on what is the actual metal temperature on these blades. So we know it's somewhere between 400 and 1200 and something, 50. And if we increase the metal temperature by 15 degrees, it can reduce the lifetime by 50%. So validation and prototyping is important for us. So we set out to map a process for this, and it incorporated the following steps. We made the design, different designs, and also a printed version of the cast design. We manufactured the blades, and we also validated material properties for two SLM materials. Also, we had to target new lifing methods, since usually this is a cast material. And we also needed to put much focus on quality controls, new types of component testing, and very advanced CT scanning. And after we've gone through that chain, we could convince ourselves that it would work, and we could perform the engine test and evaluate the blade and the new designs. And we got some recognitions from doing this test. We won, for example, a 3D printing industry prize for the best application in AM for last year. The other area is repair. And this is actually the first application that we identified for the SLM technique. So this is where we started back in 2009. And we have our burners today, which is about this size. And the burner tip, where the flame comes out, is the one getting damaged and burnt. So the conventional method was to take away about 10 centimeters of the tip and then weld on a new part to it. But now we found that we could just take away 20 millimeters, the area that is really damaged. And then we, together with EOS, could adapt an M280 machine to fit the whole burner into the machine and then locate the part with the laser and print directly onto the part with good results. So that is development was done and is now something we use as our standard procedure. We have about 2 years of field experience for this, with also good results. And the next step after that application was to think, okay, can we do more than just print the tip? So we started looking at, can we redesign the whole burner front? This is the conventional burner front that was manufactured from 13 different parts being welded together. It had thermal barrier coating on the front surface and an external pilot gas feed. So our designers got the task to incorporate this into one part and design it for printing. And the design is now fully adapted to AM. So it's one single part being printed. It's printed without support structure. That was one key target to reach. We also could then optimize the cooling of the burner front. And we can also integrate the pilot gas feed into the structure. And we can also improve the mixing of fuel that will link to this hydrogen variant of the burner that we also work with. And at the same time, we reduced the lead time a lot, and we reduced the weight also. So today we have this installed in one of the customer sites. So that's been one application with very good fit for AM technique. For spare parts on demand, we have some different examples. But I chose one here because it was made for a nuclear power plant in Krosno in Slovenia. And it was also the first 3D printed water pump impeller that is in commercial operation at the nuclear power plant, with all that comes with such regulations and certificates, etc. And the customer benefits that is there is that obsolete parts can be reproduced. We can also reduce the lead time significantly, and having the service of spare parts on demand. And this project was also just recently awarded on the TCT application award. So that was some examples of applications that we work with. And while working with the applications, we also simultaneously work on the challenges with this new technology. And some of the challenges we target is the topics of AM machines and also standards. And when it comes to the machines, future needs could be increased size of the components. It's also to introduce a closed process control loop and parameter monitoring, the whole quality part of the supply chain. We're looking at scanning for positioning and control of that. And then we obviously want to increase the process speed to reduce the cost. We also see challenges for the standards. We see a need to develop and implement international standards for the sintering process. We have active membership in the International Standards Committee. We obviously do much cooperation with universities and also with the suppliers of machine and powder. And when it comes to challenges regards more from the R&D and component development side, we see these four areas as also key areas, meaning material development, mechanical integrity, heat transfer and flow simulations, and then concept and CAD modeling. All of these are very closely interlinked, and we're trying to work very closely between these fields, so to say. When it comes to materials, we're working on areas like extending the material validation, property validation, test programs for SLM materials that we use already, but we need more knowledge. We also try to optimize new alloys, new compositions, to match the lifing requirements of more components where we see potential. We're also looking at new SLM materials for different components, maybe existing materials. And we work very closely in the serial production part of our company. Powder quality, we've talked a lot about today, and all the questions that comes with that. Also looking at machine dependency on material properties. Could it vary between different machines, etc.? So we have many, many topics on powder. When it comes to mechanical integrity, that is another important area. We try to develop material models continuously when the material data is available. It's typically much less than when we work with conventional materials. We work also with simulation methods for new type of concepts. How can we model, how can we simulate such concepts like thin walls, lattices? We're looking at crack propagation methods for these materials. And we try to explore also the topology optimization area and see how can that fit into our components. Another important area is the heat transfer and flow. We need to be able to predict and simulate the heat transfer with these type of components. We know that the surface roughness will be much higher. It will affect the heat transfer pressure drop. And we also need to develop correlations for this. So we do a lot of heat transfer rig testing and pressure drop rig testing, which then feeds into the simulation that feeds into the mechanical integrity topic. And last but not least, we have the concept and CAD modeling. Again, we come into how can we model these very advanced geometries like thin walls, lattices, in-wall cooling, And how can we develop the digital interface and the tools between both CAD and CAM, and how can they integrate in a good way? And we need also to learn and document the design rules and the conditions for it. So, in conclusion, to summarize, Siemens consider AM as a game changer, and they invest heavily in AM, both locally here in Finspång, but also globally. And Siemens has taken the step into serial production. And one part of that is that we have the Finspång AM workshop with the 12 EOS machines. And we have several years of experience now for different components in the fleet. And we have identified the three pillars of AM, where we use the prototyping, repair and spare parts on demand, and rapid manufacturing. And some of the research areas identified are the development of the machines, the standards, the need for that, material development, of course, and then also the whole integrated design philosophy, design for AM, including the simulation part of it, of course. Yeah, that was all for me. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.